What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. I know I don't usually say that, but this video I feel like is catered more towards people who have been here for a while. So if you haven't been here for a while, hello, my name is Zoe. And a lot of the references in this video will be to do with previous hair videos that I have. So I will link the playlist of those down below. It's very helpful stuff. So just thought I would throw that out there. So if you've asked me a question in the past 6 months, I can almost 99.9% guarantee that you will get your answer in this video. My inbox is flooded with a lot of the same questions. I've actually had a lot of trouble keeping up with them. So I thought today was a good day to finally sit down and give you guys some of the answers that you have been asking for. So first of all, I'm going to go right back to the beginning of all this, and I'm going to be talking about the Bumble and Bumble hair powder, brownish hair powder that I spoke about in my first hair video. I've been asked multiple times if I still use this, and the answer is sometimes. Definitely not the way that I used to. So back then when I made that video, I was using it every single time I washed my hair. It was basically like as common as shampoo to me. Like I was just using it that frequently all the time. My hair was never not covered in powder. That is not the case anymore. If I use this, it will be for like, you know, if I'm going out or something, if it's somebody's birthday party and I just want to make sure that my hair is like perfect looking, then I will still use this, yes, because there's nothing wrong with this product. It's never let me down. This is a great product, and if you are looking for like hair thinness coverage like that video was suggesting, then I do still highly recommend this product. It is great. Now, coming off that product, I did make a video I think a month or two after I spoke about that one, and it was some other options that I tried as far as hair concealment, scalp concealment, I guess. I tried three other things besides that, and the only one that I've somewhat stuck with since then has been the L'Oreal Magic Root Cover-Up. A lot of people talk about this and reference it. Yes, it is a root cover-up, but it does the same thing. Like it achieves what you need it to. And I really like this because sometimes my hair is darker. Like the brownish hair powder, it is fairly light, and although it's not noticeable after I'm done with it, it's not like perfect. Where if I'm doing like a ponytail or something when my hair is closer to my head and it's like really easy to see where you've like sprayed your scalp, that's why I'll use this one. This one, in comparison to the Bumble and Bumble spray, is that I feel like the color is a lot more intense. And also they have color options. So they have so many different colors for blonde, redheads, brown hair, black hair. This one is dark brown, but it is a lot darker than the Bumble and Bumble one. But because this one feels a little more heavy duty than that one, like this one feels like I'm putting like paint on my hair, I'm very hesitant in using it. I will barely use this. Only if I'm like going to the fucking Oscars or something, I will use this. Like this is actually the same can from back then. It's got a decent amount in it, so I barely use it, but it is good to have around. It's very handy. In that same video, I used the Batiste Divine Dark dry shampoo, and I did finish that. But one beef that I had while using that was that I was never really a huge fan of the result. It just kind of felt heavy. It felt like I was putting baby powder in my hair. Like the amount that you had to put in to get the color payoff was just, it felt very unhealthy for my scalp. I'm not saying that it is. I'm not a scientist. I don't know that. It just didn't feel right to me to have hair like that cakey feeling. So that's why I am not a huge fan of that. And no, I have not bought that again. And the Topic hair fiber powder or whatever's, I mean, you guys saw how that turned out. It was awful. And I just don't really have the interest to try that again when I have like aerosol options. Okay, now I want to talk to you guys about Olaplex. I mentioned that I was using this for majority of last year in my hair update video. I went pretty far in depth like how I was using it and how much I loved it. I still do love Olaplex a lot. I am actually back to using Olaplex right now. I have been for all of July, and I will explain why in a second, but just to touch on a main concern I keep getting from people is a little bit of confusion and honestly sometimes frustration, because people have mentioned to me that they think I'm like switching things up and I'm trying to just like push things on you, and that is absolutely not what's happening. If I see something new that I want to try, then I will try it for you guys, and that's exactly what I did. It had absolutely nothing to do with Olaplex not working or just, you know, not being a good product, because that couldn't be further from the truth. I love Olaplex. I will probably never stop using the shampoo and conditioner from Olaplex. It still makes my hair feel so soft. I can tell that my actual hair strands get healthier every single time I use the system. It's just a very effective way to maintain your hair's health and your scalp's health. without having to do like hair masks and treatments and stuff. Because I shampoo and condition my hair like, you know, 2-3 times a week, it just maintains my hair feeling good. So that's why I like Olaplex a lot. And I will compare it to Bonday Boost, which I know is what most of you guys are here for, so that's what I'm going to be speaking on now. So, Bonday Boost. This has been the main question for the past 4 months. I get a request for an update almost every single day. Even a week after I made that video, everyone was very interested in how it was going. The only reason I haven't made that video yet is because I didn't feel like my hair was like showing obvious enough of a difference to like make a whole video about it. So that's why I'm kind of inserting it into this video. Hopefully that will provide some clarity for people. So after I finished filming that video, keep in mind that video was a month span of already using it. So you guys saw the results after 1 month of using it. I did continue to use it for another 3 months. So I used it in total all of March, April, May, and June. And then the conditioner ran out, and then the shampoo ran out, and then the conditioning mask ran out. The only two that I have left is the everyday spray, which has a decent amount in it. It's got like half left in it. And I still have the oil, but that I feel like is running thin at the moment. After I finished that month of filming, I have to be honest, I wasn't as diligent in like keeping up with the routine. It was a lot for me to do that, even just for that month. It takes a lot of time to like sit around with masks in your hair and oil and like time it right in between like having to do things. So I wasn't like perfectly on the schedule that I was, but I was still using it when I could. I would do like the conditioning mask 1 week, and then I would do the oil mask another week. Like I tried to fit it in as best as I could. And instead of using this intensive spray every day, I only put it in my hair straight after I've washed it when it's already wet. I feel like it dries better that way. It just felt a little weird putting it on dry hair. It's not like, it didn't make my hair look weird or anything when it dried. It's just like usually, I don't know, it takes a second to dry, so it kind of looks like you have an oily scalp for a while. Sort of bummed me out. So that's why I just did it when it was wet. So my hair right now is the result of using the Bonday Boost system for 4 months. But this is how my scalp looks today, 4 to 5 months down the road from using Bonday Boost, although for the past month I've been using Olaplex, but I don't think I've seen like a dramatic difference since then. While using Bonday Boost, I did see a dramatic increase in my baby hairs. Like I was seeing a lot of tiny little new growths coming out of places in my scalp where there just hadn't been hair growth before. So I can confirm that in my case, it did work for new growth, which is essentially what it claimed to do and what I was hoping it would do. I'm pretty happy with my hair these days. I know that it's still thin, and by no stretch of the imagination is it a thick head of hair, but it has definitely gotten a lot better than my original video from almost 2 years ago now. And that's really all I wanted. A main question that I get asked a lot is, if I could only buy one thing or use one thing, would I choose Bonday Boost or Olaplex? Like, which is the better one to use? And I usually don't have a short answer for that because I believe that they both work fantastically together. Not to say that either one won't work singularly, I just feel like I've gotten such amazing results in the past year because I've been alternating the two. And if you did watch all of that Bonday Boost video, I did say that I was going to continue to alternate between the two because I don't like using the same shampoo and conditioner every single time. Towards the end of using Olaplex the first time, I did feel like my hair was not like extremely reaping the benefits like it did at the beginning, so I wanted to focus on another area. And then I just found Bonday Boost and they were really promoting the hair growth aspect of it, so that's why I tried that and I thought it would be interesting for you guys to see how that worked for me. I boiled down a lot of my hair loss issues, besides the stress aspect of it, being different factors. And one of them was that I was just using really bad products on my hair. So I was always a person who just got shampoo, conditioner, hairspray, whatever from the grocery store. So it would be like Pantene, Herbal Essences, that OGX stuff, like basic stuff that you can find in Target. There was no like Nioxin, there wasn't any Redken or, you know, like higher end salon brands. I was just using the cheapest thing because those products were like as common as toothpaste. So I was just trying to like fill a need and not actually take care of my hair. And keep in mind too, my hair was in pretty bad shape. Like the strands of my hair, I had dead ends like crazy. You guys have seen how long my hair is, so it's pretty old Like the hair strands, they've been there for a good minute, so my hair does need a lot of love. And that's the reason why I will continue to use Olaplex, because it is great for not only your hair's health, but your scalp's health. I've had so many people tell me and read so many things about how using some of the generic shampoo and conditioners can like sort of clog your scalp area and just make it a bad environment for hair to want to grow. And I have a feeling that after doing that for so many years, it was making my hair loss issues worse. In my personal experience, backing that up is that the second that I started using Olaplex, unless it truly is a miracle product, it made my hair not only start to grow longer again, but I did notice that I was having more hair growth, more fullness, like my whole hair scalp situation just perked up. And I think that's important. Even though I would say that the Bondi Boost system definitely is more of a powerhouse as far as hair growth, it's like the natural solution to Rogaine or something like that. Like it is very specific to like hair growth. Olaplex is more for like hair and scalp health, which I think both of those things are important. If you have healthy hair, healthy scalp, you're like you're already using pretty nice salon or natural hair products on your hair, then you might not even need to use Olaplex. You could use Bondi Boost if all you're really looking for is hair growth, but that wasn't my case. For me, however, it is not over for Bondi Boost. As I said, I will be alternating, so once I am finished using the Olaplex shampoo and conditioner, I will be purchasing the Bondi Boost system again. Of course, that is an Australian brand, so I'm not sure how they're going with shipping right now with the situation of the world. If you've ordered from them recently, let me know down below so that everybody knows what that situation is, but hopefully by the time I finish my Olaplex, I will be able to get Bondi Boost again. And hopefully in a year's time from now, maybe I'll be making another video from going back and forth so often and my hair will be like way thicker, who knows? But I feel like all of this stuff takes time. That's another reason I wasn't rushing into making this update, because I didn't want to make pointless videos of like barely any progress. It does take time. There is no overnight miracle for this. So that is the update, the Bondi Boost update, the Olaplex update, any kind of update that you guys wanted. Those are all the main questions that I get. If I didn't answer your question, I would be highly surprised, but maybe I just didn't see it. So please feel free to leave any questions that you have still down below, and I will do my very best to answer them. I also want to make it very clear that I'm not doing this just to like push things on anyone. Any of the products in this video, nobody sponsored me for at all. I bought all of these products myself, so not that I would ever work with a brand that I didn't believe in myself, but if it makes you feel any better, I have absolutely no financial reasons to be like telling you guys to buy any of this. I'm literally just trying to help. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I would love to have you as part of the family. I love you guys. I make a new video every week, so I will see you in the next one. Bye guys.